ethnicity should enrich us. It should make us a unique people in our diversity and not be used to divide us. To girls and women everywhere, I issue a simple invitation. My sisters, my daughters, my friends, find your voice. Leadership is never given on a silver platter. One has to earn it. Once the glass ceiling has been broken, it can never be put back together. However one would try to do that. I believe that there are certain attributes in a woman that give her some advantages over a man. Women are usually more honest, more sensitive to issues and bring a stronger sense of commitment and dedication to what they do. Maybe because they were mothers. And being a mother, you have that special attention for the family, for the young, for children. Women are working for change. And I will be with them. And one of them. Forever. I demand more rights for women because I know what women can do. We ask justice. We ask equality. We ask that all the civil and political rights that belong to all citizens be guaranteed to us and our daughters. Seeing gender as integral to the economy brings the true value of women into the conversation. There will always be those who will tear us down and tear us apart because they want the status quo to remain. But together we can break down the barriers that have kept women from achieving the equity they rightfully deserve. The future belongs to us. Because we have taken charge of it. We have the commitment. We have the resourcefulness. And we have the strength of our people to share the dream across Africa of clean water for all. I stand by it. I take the criticism for it. I think it's unfair. But yes, there is a thing about nepotism. And we all try to respect it. I work hard. I work late. I have nothing on my conscience. When I go to bed, I sleep. I underestimated the low level of capacity. I also underestimated the cultural roots of corruption. I beg you, I know magician. I can't just wave a magic wand. I think we're ready for succession. We just must try to do it right. Liberia just needs to go through this one political transition. And it can really take off. Everything's in place now. We cannot afford to put the country in the hands of someone that lacks the experience. I've been involved in politics for quite some time. I've held positions. And my experiences are very deep. And I think I have the capacity, the courage, and the character to institute the kinds of reforms that are so desperately needed. I'm not talking about what you hear from 5% of the population on the radio. In the papers. I don't pay attention to it. I travel around the country. I'm happy I have a good relationship with the people. As more men become more educated and women get educated, the value system has to be more enhanced and the respect for human dignity and human life is made better. I just think that unless you have that cohesiveness in the family unit, the male character tends to become very dominant, repressive and insensitive. So much of this comes also from a lack of education. In terms of being able to renew my nation. To be able to bring back a devastated country. To restore hope to our people. To lift women and to give them a new horizon. A new ambition and new dreams. In respect of all of that. I think we've accomplished it. And I feel very good about that. My mother was a disciplinarian. She believed that when young girls start to go out with young boys, they get married. When I took office, Liberia began to recover from years of neglect. Our people have brought clean water into the heart of Monrovia to children who have never known water from a tap. Efforts are underway to expand water projects as much as possible throughout the country. I think the majority of the Liberian people want peace. I would like to make sure, first of all, that our women in the informal sector, I mean, these are the farmers and the traders. Many of them are not educated. Many of them lacking literacy. Be able to give them better working conditions. And we've done a lot to be able to achieve that. One has to look at my life story to see what I've done. I've paid a heavy price that many people don't realize. We've done a lot to restore Liberia's credibility, Liberia's reputation, Liberia's presence. We have to overcome the practice of male domination, even though it's changing. and changing in Liberia quite drastically. All girls know that they can be anything now. That transformation is to me one of the most satisfying things. Women work harder, and women are more honest. They have less reasons to be corrupt. The people of Liberia know what it means to be deprived of clean water. But we also know what it means to see our children to begin to smile again with a restoration of hope and faith in the future. I don't think people understand the awesomeness of the destruction of this country, its institutions, its infrastructure, its law, its morals. My mother was the strength. She was the anchor. She was a preacher and a teacher. My calling was first of all to ensure there was peace in the country. Because we could easily have gone back to war. In the midst of the country, there were still warlords. There were many child soldiers who had never gone to school. They were part of the social setting. Compromises had to be made. The size of your dreams must always exceed your current capacity to achieve them. If your dreams do not scare you, they are not big enough. Future generations will judge us not by what we say, but what we do. If your dreams do not scare you, they are not big enough. We are here because we share a fundamental belief that poverty, illiteracy, disease and inequality do not belong in the 21st century. We share a common purpose to eradicate these ills for the benefit of all. And we share a common tool to achieve this. Of course, I am the first democratically elected woman president in Africa. And that raises a lot of expectations. Because I represent the aspirations of women all over Africa, I must succeed for them. I must keep the door open for women's participation in politics at the highest level. That is both humbling and exciting. I work hard. I work late. I have nothing on my conscience. When I go to bed, I sleep. Women work harder. And women are more honest. They have less reasons to be corrupt. I don't run a woman government. I run a government of people. I've been a victor of circumstance. I don't face any particular problems as a woman president because I have been a professional for a long time. I keep telling people, I am a technocrat who happens to be a woman. I just think that unless you have that cohesiveness in the family unit, the male character tends to become very dominant, repressive and insensitive. So much of this comes also from a lack of education. I earned my professional credibility a long time ago in a male-dominated world. I just hope that as a woman, I bring in an extra dimension to the job. I bring in the sensitivity of being a woman and a mother. And that means I pay more attention to women, children, and the social needs of society. Liberia can move on and break from the past. That is very important for us to try to achieve our development goals and reconcile our nation. Our entire judicial system in Liberia has broken down because of the many years of lawlessness, indiscipline and warfare. We need more training to get more qualified judges. We need infrastructural reforms. All of our laws need to be re-examined by a law reform commission. There is no easy fix or youth unemployment. Partnership between the public and private sectors can make a big difference.